Tom Brady went to a prep school down in Tampa Bay and got some work in with his teammates. O.J. Howard was there. O.J. Howard, by the way, if you do recall, was potentially on the trading block. They bring in Gronk. Allegedly, O.J. Howard, who's a very talented tight end, was not happy about this. So to hear that O.J. Howard is out there training with Tom Brady at this prep school, good news. I believe Mike Evans was also there. I'm not 100% sure if Godwin was there. It would look like I saw Blaine Gabbert there as well throwing alongside him. So it feels like Tom Brady is getting the boys together down in Tampa. This was a big thing that we talked about with this new offense coming in. Is it going to be the Tom Brady offense or the Bruce Arians offense? We talked to B.A. B.A. said, well, it's going to be our offense, but obviously anytime you get a chance to talk to Tom Brady, you're going to add him in there a little bit. So we were wondering, will Tom Brady and the boys have enough time with this quarantine to be able to get on the same page? Will Tom Brady and the boys, since Tom Brady's being kicked out of parks, be able to exercise and work out with his new wide receivers and get timing down? Here he is going to a prep school down there. He's playing, I believe it looks like guard at this point. but I like this for them, and I like this for the Buccaneers because they are behind in their training because they're playing against Drew Brees and the Saints in the NFC South. They have the same offense. They have the same exact setup. They're ready to go for next year. Sean Payton actually said, we're not doing a Zoom meetings. I'll see you at training camp. You've got the Atlanta Falcons who have Matt Ryan, Julio Jones, and a lot of their offense back. Bring in Todd Gurley. He's going to have to get up to speed. Teddy Bridgewater going to Carolina. They're going to have the same problems, but everybody thought Tampa might have problems because in the first year in Bruce Arians' offense, you are known to throw a lot of interceptions. Carson Palmer did it. Jameis Winston threw 30 last year. Tom Brady's first year in Bruce Arians' offense, they were going to need some time to gel and mold. They're doing that at a prep school. I like to see this. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers, all of a sudden, all the way back up in the NFC in my eyes.
Huge for them. I mean, this is like huge for them. Any team with a new quarterback, like you said, this is big for it. If the restrictions get loosened a little bit and the facilities aren't open yet because not everyone could open, but you could go to a local high school.
Well, you got to remember, Tom Brady's throwing at the local high school here with some of the boys trying to learn the offense and get the timing down. Nobody says anything. Governor's probably applauding this.
Yeah.
Ben Roethlisberger goes out there and throws with his teammates, get his beard trimmed, and the governor, who's a Philadelphia Eagles fan, comes out and starts chirping about how that's bad. How about morale boost in Pittsburgh, governor?
Yeah.
Hello, governor. Hello, governor. I ate a bag of fornicators, governor. That's what everybody in Pittsburgh is saying, not us. But I like that Tom Brady's getting that work in. Leadership, by the way. Good leadership by Tom Brady putting this together. And he's wearing full pads, and he's making others wear pads as well, which I didn't see
before. I was going to say, I didn't see Blaine wearing pads. You think he's judging Blaine like, hey, this is why you didn't really pan out?
He had his helmet on, though, didn't he?
Yeah.
No shoulder pads, but he had his helmet on. I didn't know this many people trained with their helmets on, by the way. Tom Brady was one of the first people who was like, oh, this guy trains in full gear in the offseason. I did not know
Tom
that.
Tom was walking the routes for Mike Evans, showing him exactly where to cut. This is going to be a lot of Tom's offense.
And by the way, well, maybe Tom just expects you to be at a certain spot for a slant or whatever. Like, hey, whenever you run a slant, this is where I would like you at. And remember, Tom Brady said on Howard Stern, he said, if I don't trust the guy, I'm not going to throw him the ball. So you can put a guy on the field or whatever all you want. If I don't trust him, I'm not going to throw the ball. And trust means I know where he's going to be. He knows where he's going to be. We're on the same exact page. What were you going to say, Z?
Is it weird there's no Gronk there?
Oh, trouble in paradise.
OJ Howard's diner, isn't he?
Well, he's when you want your both tight ends to be together?
He's 24/7 champ, so he's
Gotta... Gronk also, he just run, catch ball, spike ball, you know, he doesn't need to practice.
Well, Gronk might not have been in town yet, by the way. He might have been moving or something like that. I would assume Gronkowski will be at these workouts. I think that's a big thing Tom Brady likes to do, is he likes to throw with his guys, as do all premier quarterbacks, by the way. They like to get in throwing sessions with their guys.